Qantas engineers are preparing to walk off the job over pay, which could see major delays for travellers from next week. Let's go live to Gabrielle Boyle, who's at Sydney Airport. Gabby, what are workers calling for?
Ali, they're being very clear about exactly what they want. Qantas engineers are calling for a 12% pay rise, while their Jetstar colleagues are asking for a 15% pay rise to play out over the next 4 years. They've been at the negotiating table with the airlines for 4 years now. All of this started back in 2019. They're not ruling out strike action. It could kick in as early as Monday next week. They've told us they will start with a one-minute strike and it will escalate from there if the negotiating process is not successful. Here at the domestic terminal, passengers are naturally pretty frustrated with the possibility of further strike action given the extensive delays and problems we've seen at airports in recent months.
Disappointing.
They've had a couple of years of not being able to work, and so, you know, the fact that they can't get staff immediately, you know, I kind of understand.
It's all part of travel, isn't it? You've got to enjoy the journey.
Qantas has called this action extremely disappointing and they say they are willing to negotiate with the engineers. Ali? Okay.
Thanks for your company this morning. Well, there is no denying it. It is a punish to travel at the moment. There are delays, lost bags, cancellations, and now 700 Qantas engineers are planning to walk off the job next week over a pay. We're joined by Liberal MP Stuart Robert and Deputy Editor of the Daily Telegraph, Anna Caldwell, here in the studio. Nice to see you both. So, Stuart, I mean, this is just what passengers need, right? Even more delays and cancellations. But what I'm not sure, if the engineers aren't working, is it even safe to fly?
Ali, no engineers, no flying. It's that simple. If something possibly goes wrong with an aircraft, that's what you're looking for. And of course, airlines won't take the risk quite rightly. It is quite a disastrous situation, and they're looking for pay rises of up to 14%. This is the problem when governments promise everyone is going to get a pay rise. Well, government will have to work with Qantas on this, but we're already seeing lots of airlines delayed and baggages lost and the like. It's difficult and it's expensive right now to fly. So this is not good news for travellers.
So you're saying the engineers don't deserve that pay rise?
14% hit in 1 year. Last time we saw that was in the Gough Whitlam inflation days in 1972 when wages rose at 18% driven by government policy of the day. That's a very, very unprecedented large rise in salary in one go.
And the thing is, while all this is going on, right, we're caught in the middle. I mean, I have two mates whose bags have been missing for 9 days now. 9 days. And it was even last night, airline staff couldn't tell them what state these bags were in. They didn't know. And I mean, I think people just aren't looking forward to travelling anymore because it's chaotic.
Totally. Flying is a debacle at the moment. You know, you've got the lineups, you've got the missing bags. That's why I think, you know, this suggestion of strike is actually just so unfair on travellers. You know, fine for the engineers to fight for their pay increase. I think Stuart Roberts right, you know, 14%. How many of the travellers do they think are getting 14% pay increases? Nobody's getting a 14% pay rise. And the people who suffer are people who are just trying to go about their business, you know, get interstate, possibly see family, maybe go on holiday, but they deserve to be able to do it seamlessly.
Travelling has become miles more complicated since our post-pandemic return to the skies, and the problems just keep on coming, with 700 Qantas engineers now planning to walk off the job next week.
Let's get today's take with us with commentator Jane Carrow and host of the Briefing podcast, Tom Tilley. Tom, I mean, obviously, people who are going to be flying next week are not wanting to hear this news, but these problems just keep occurring.
Well, it's one thing to lose your bags. It's another thing to lose a wheel off the plane, isn't it?
Yeah.
Engineers, that's kind of where the rubber hits the road, pardon the pun, and this is pretty serious. I mean, I'd love to have Alan Jones's pay packet, but his job right now is so tough. And obviously, he makes that much money because he saved them so much money by outsourcing so many parts of the business, and that strategy is starting to bite him.
Well, Qantas's reputation all really hinges on safety, yeah, doesn't it, Jane? So this could be a big issue for them.
Yeah, I mean, the engineers know their power. We're seeing it in all sorts of workplaces at the moment, teachers, nurses, childcare workers, now Qantas engineers, all sorts of people are recognising that the market has flipped. It's now a worker's market, not a boss's market, and that's what happens. And actually, you know what, it's about time. Most of these people have been ripped off, overworked and underpaid for far too long. It's time we started to pay people who have huge hugely responsible jobs, like the Qantas engineers,
yeah,
what they're worth and what the value is to our society.
It's a double whammy, though. Because of inflation, their real wages are going down.
Correct.
So there's, like, two really good reasons.
And interest rates are going up, so they can't pay their mortgages, energy bills. I mean, we're caught in a perfect storm.
There is some, though, who'll say, who will argue, well, they're asking for, what, a 14% pay rise? Is that too much to ask for? And, you know, you're only hurting customers by doing this, not necessarily the company. What would you say to that?
Well, there's a lot of demand for flights at the moment, and passengers seem to be willing to pay it. I guess that's where the negotiation has to kick in on what's right for the business, the customers, but keeping these engineers on the job. And if they're at the point of walking off the job, then...
It's also... I mean, it's a bad publicity title saying, like, it's 14%. That's how you negotiate. You go in high and you get what you want. You know what I mean? They might get 7, but that's what they want.
And also, I thought capitalism likes supply and demand. Just doesn't like it when it works for the ordinary guys, huh?